In this lecture, we are going to see about the design of LF. The first factor which affects the LF, the first parameter is armature reaction. We know that armature reaction is the effect of armature flux over the field flux, or else you can say main winding flux, which is known as armature reaction. Okay, so whenever we increase the air gap, what exactly happens with the armature reaction? Before proceeding there, we have to just understand a small basic about armature reaction.
Stator. Or you can say stationary portion, that is field winding. Whereas this portion is armature. So, whenever we increase this particular air gap length, LG, what actually happens is the effect of the armature flux over the main flux will get deviated. And one more important thing is, if we are keeping the air gap length further large, we have to increase the amount of the field flux produced in the that main winding. So that is the case, whenever we have the large air gap, the field has to be increased further. So the meaning is, in this point of moment, armature reaction can be reduced further. This is the case. The second parameter is circulating gap. If we are keeping the air gap length smaller, due to the irregularities present in that particular air gap, will lead to maximum flux deviation. So this will lead to increase the circulating current in the winding. This has to be reduced. The third parameter which disturbs the air gap length design is pole phase losses. Whenever we keep the air gap length larger, what actually happens? The flux density present in this particular air gap will get reduced due to the large amount of this air gap length. So due to this, the pulsation loss in the particular pole will get reduces. The next parameter we are going to see is cooling and noise. This is very obvious. If we are keeping the large air gap, so that the air circulation should be proper. So due to this, air circulation is more good, the ventilation will be appropriate. So we can say the cooling will be best if we are keeping the large air gap, so that the noise of the particular machine also get reduces whenever we keep the large air gap. The last parameter is mechanical consideration, that is nothing but magnetic pull. In small air gap machine, the unbalanced magnetic pull will get increases. Due to this, what actually happens is the rotor and stator will face into some kind of vibration. Whereas if we keep the air gap length further more, I mean large air gap length, will helps to reduce this unbalanced magnetic pull. The meaning is, the magnetic pull will be properly balanced. Due to this, we can avoid the unwanted vibration. So which leads to, mechanically, the machine will be strong and rigid in construction. The estimation of air gap is explained here.